Wakey, wakey. I gather you had a nice sleep. I took the liberty of removing your weapons and our radio. I suppose you've got a few questions on your mind, like, where are the other employees? All you need to know is that they're very secure, and unfortunately they share the same fate as you. Death. You see, what you probably aren't aware of is that right now, as we speak, the company car park is packed with enough explosive to turn this building into rubble. And I have full intention of making you see it to the very end. I think it's the least I can do, after your antics tonight.
Frank, we're moving the last dash of the money.
Ah, at last. Let me know when you're done. You look surprised. What, you thought we needed the access codes? Ha, you stupid. We knew where you were as soon as you picked up that radio. Ever heard of a locator device? This is where we say our goodbyes. You know how it is. Places to go, companies to rob. I'll see you in another life. Max, is there still no sign of that security guard?
No, there's still no sign, Frank.
Okay, relay me onto the company speaker.
Okay, it's ready.
Attention, Mr. Porter. We gave you your chance. You chose to defy us. You even sent your friend to do your own dirty work. Your attempt has failed. Max?
Yes, sir?
Kill his wife. If there are any terrorists in the building who are not yet aware, our goal is complete. We got what we came for. There are only a few seconds left before the building goes down, so get out while you can and get to the room.
Good morning, I'm Trevor Jones, and welcome to KBC News. A few hours ago, the company headquarters of Parcel Passages was completely destroyed. Initial reports indicate that terrorists were involved. We're now going to go to Sally Lloyd, live at the scene. Good morning, Sally.
Yes, good morning, Trevor. As you can see behind me, the local fire departments have begun a frantic rescue operation, sifting through the rubble, hoping to find survivors. Over the past hour, I have spoken to two or three eyewitnesses who believe they saw someone through the windows. He was seen armed and was wearing a blue shirt. Another thing that has been brought up is the emergency lights on the roof. Apparently, these lights were switched on a while before the building collapsed, yet no authorities arrived at the scene.
I know it's early, but do the authorities have an estimated death toll at this moment?
As far as estimated figures go, they are unsure at this time. However, they believe there were only a few employees in the building at that time.
Thank you very much, Sally. I'm sure we'll be hearing more about this over the coming weeks. But for now, I'm Trevor Jones, and you were watching KBC News. Have a safe day. Thank you.